Good morning, one and all. Myself is Dr. Swati, and I'm here to explain the classification of organic compounds, which is a part of Unit 1 for the B-Pharmacy second semester students. So what is organic chemistry first? So it is a discipline or branch of chemistry that studies the structure and properties and reactions of carbon compounds. Okay, so what are the structure, properties and reactions of the compounds? It is nothing but the chemistry of the compound. Okay, so we can also define organic chemistry as the simply chemistry of carbon compounds, because many of the organic compounds majorly consist of carbon as one of the element. Okay, so we can consider organic chemistry as the chemistry of carbon compounds. Now, what do you mean by structure? Structure can be determined in terms of the chemical composition or formula. Okay, we can tell in terms of the composition of the material that is given organic substance, or we can just mention its molecular formula also. Okay, so that is what the meaning of the structure here. And what are these properties and reactions? So depending on the type of bonding present in each and every organic compound, the molecules will have certain physical properties as well as chemical properties. Depending on the chemical properties, they will exhibit their reactions. So each and every class of organic compounds are having their own typical reactions. Okay, so the properties includes physical, chemical properties and evaluation of the chemical reactivity. So why we need to evaluate the chemical reactivity is to understand the behavior of these organic compounds. So let us see the classification of the organic compounds. So these organic compounds can be classified in two ways. The first one is based on the arrangement of the carbon chain that the molecules are having. They can be classified, that means whether it is an open chain carbon or the carbon chain is cyclic ring form, and again in cyclic ring form also there are various modes are there. So based on the arrangement of carbon chain they can be classified, and also depending on the functional group present in them also they can be classified. So let us see these classifications one by one with definitions and examples. So the first one is classification of the organic compounds based on the arrangement of carbon chain. So based on the network of this carbon chain or backbone present in organic compounds, they are again divided into four major types. So the first class of agents are known as aliphatic compounds, and the second one are known as alicyclic compounds, and third class is aromatic compounds, and the last one is known as heterocyclic compounds. Okay, so based on the arrangement of carbon chain, these organic compounds are classified into aliphatic, alicyclic, aromatic and heterocyclic compounds. So let us see these four classes with the definitions and examples. So the first class of agents based on the carbon chain are the aliphatic compounds. Okay, so what are these organic aliphatic type of the organic compounds is? These are the compounds in which carbon atoms are present in open chain form. Okay, so these are the open chain form molecules. They are also synonymously known as open chain molecules. That means carbon chain will be present in open chain form. Okay, so what do you mean by open chain form? Let us see few examples. So the first one is two carbon containing alkane, that is called ethane. And the next one is 1, 2, 3 carbon containing alkene. The functional group is alkene, so we call it as 1-propene. And the next one is known as ethanol. So ethyl group is present with alcohol, it is known as ethanol, and 3 carbon containing aldehyde is called propanol. The suffix is going to indicate the class of the organic compound here. And 2 carbon, that is ethyl group with amine, is known as ethanamine. Okay, so these are the IUPAC names of the molecules with structures are given here. So in all these examples you can see carbon is present in their open chain form. Okay, so that is why all these are the examples for the aliphatic compounds. Now if you once again observe these first two molecules, they are made up of only carbon and hydrogens in both the examples. Okay, so they are also further known as hydrocarbons. That is, organic compounds which are made up of only carbon and hydrogen are known as hydrocarbons. So this is about aliphatic compounds. Let us move to the next one, alicyclic compounds. So the name itself indicates there will be cyclic system. So that means these are the organic compounds in which carbon atoms are present in cyclic ring form. The previous one, that is aliphatic compounds, we have seen carbon chain is present in open chain form. But here the carbon chain is present in cyclic ring formation. So let us see the examples here. So the first one is called cyclopentane. You can see each corner of this geometrical figure. By default, there will be a CH2 unit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons are there in this molecule. So the corresponding saturated hydrocarbon is called pentane. As these 5 carbons are in cyclic ring form, we'll keep cyclo word prefixed to the name of the parent hydrocarbon. So that is how this 5-membered compound becomes cyclopentane. And similarly, next one, there are 6 carbon. The ring is made up of 6 carbons. So it is called cyclohexane. And the third example, you can see it is almost looking like the structure of cyclohexane only, but having a double bond. So compounds having double bond are known as alkenes. So we name it as cyclohexane. So in all these examples, you can see carbon atoms are present in cyclic ring form, either 5-member, 4-member, 6-member rings and so on. Okay, so this is about alicyclic compounds. And the third class of agents are known as aromatic compounds. So these aromatic compounds also cyclic compounds only. The moment we say aromatic compounds, usually benzene will come into our mind. So these are the compounds where the structure and properties of these molecules will be resembling as that of the benzene. So such type of molecules are known as aromatic compounds. So let us see the examples. So this you can easily make out, this is the benzene. And the next one, benzene ring, in addition to benzene ring, there is an amine group. So benzene ring with this amine group is called aniline. And benzene ring with carboxylic acid group is known as benzoic acid. Benzene ring with aldehyde functional group is known as benzaldehyde. So in all these compounds, you can see the benzene ring is common in them. So because of the presence of this structural similarity, they exhibit the properties similar to that of benzene. That means if benzene is going to undergo electrophilic substitution reaction, even all benzenoids or aromatic compounds, they will also undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. So this is about aromatic compounds, and the last one is they are known as heterocyclic compounds. So the first three categories, whatever we observed, particularly the alicyclic compounds and aromatic compounds, the ring is made up of carbon atoms only. In addition to carbon atom, hydrogens, depending on the valency, hydrogens are attached. Okay, so they are the examples for the homocyclic system where the ring is made up of only one type of atoms, that is particularly carbon atoms. But in these compounds, the name itself indicates they are the cyclic systems, but they are hetero. That means the ring is not made up of similar kind of atoms. So that means here these are the cyclic systems in which the ring is made up of more than one kind of atom. That means other than carbon atom also will be present in the cyclic ring. So let us see some of the examples. So the first one you can see is having 4 carbons. It is a 5-member ring. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbon atoms are present with 1 nitrogen. So it is overall number of atoms involved in cyclic ring formation are 5. But 1 is other than carbon present, that is nitrogen. Okay. So this 5-member ring with nitrogen as heteroatom is called pyrrole. And 5-member ring similarly with oxygen as heteroatom is known as furan. And you can find the similar type of ring here, system. It is also a 5-member ring having 4 carbons and 1 sulfur as heteroatom. So this is called thiophene. So all these are the examples for the 5-membered heterocyclic compounds. So there are also 6-member rings, okay, like this here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 carbons are there and 1 nitrogen is there. So other than carbons also atoms are there. So it is a 6-member ring having nitrogen as the heteroatom. So this is called pyridine. So these, in all these compounds, you can see carbons are present in the cyclic ring formation. In addition to carbon, there is one heteroatom, that is other than carbon present. So the atom which is present other than carbon is known as heteroatom. So nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur are the examples for the heteroatoms. Okay, so there are many types of the heterocyclic systems are available where they may be of 5-member rings or 6-member rings with one heteroatom, or in some ring systems more than one heterocyclic atom is also present. Okay, so these are the few examples for the heterocyclic compounds. Okay, so till now we have discussed about the classification of the organic compounds based on the arrangement of carbon chain. So once again, let us see the summary. They are classified into aliphatic compounds where the carbon chain is present in open chain form. And second category, alicyclic compounds, where the carbon atoms are present in cyclic ring form. And the third class are known as benzenoids or aromatic compounds, where the structure and properties of these molecules are similar to that of benzene. And fourth class of agents are heterocyclic compounds, where other than carbon, there will be an heteroatom present in the cyclic ring system. Okay, so these are the four different classes with the examples based on the carbon chain. This is the classification of the organic compounds. So let us move to the next type of classification, where the compounds are classified based on the functional group present in them. So what is a functional group? So functional group is the one which determines the overall properties of the molecule. That means because of the presence of functional group only, the molecules attains special characteristic features to them. So let us see an example. So if you take any two classes of organic compounds like alkanes and alkyl halides, the properties of these molecules are not similar. Even though the R group, which is common in them, still they have differences because hydrogen of alkane, here it is replaced with the halogen. So the newly added group gives new properties to the resulting molecules. That is how the alkyl halides properties are different from that of the alkanes. So if the organic compounds are having differences in the functional group, so obviously they will have different properties. In similar lines, organic compounds which are having same functional groups have similar chemical properties. Why? Because it is the functional group which gives characteristic properties to the molecule. So as long as the functional group is common, the compounds exhibit similar chemical properties. For example, alkanes, either it may be one carbon alkane or n number of carbon atoms are present, their chemical reaction, that is their ability to undergo free radical substitution, will be similar. Okay, so they will undergo similar type of free radical substitution reactions. Only depending on the structure of the alkane, the rate of reactivity will differ. Okay, now let us see the classification based on the functional group. Okay, so these are the major classes of the compounds I have given here. First class, alkanes, where the molecule is composed of carbon-carbon single bonds. So this was the example, ethane, which is having two carbon chains. The second category are the alkenes, where carbon-carbon double bond is the functional group. So ethene is the example. Like that, for each organic compound category, the functional group and the example is given. Alkynes, which is characterized by a triple bond. Alcohols, OH group, is the functional group. Ethers, that is a divalent oxygen, is the functional group. Aldehyde, CH4 group, is the functional group. Ketones, these are the organic compounds which are having CO group as the functional group. And carboxylic acid, the organic compounds which are having carboxylic group, that is COOH group, are known as carboxylic acids. Similarly, alkyl halides, where halogen, in addition to the alkyl chain, there will be a particular halogen present in them. And amines, the organic compounds which are having an H2 group or substituted nitrogen, are known as amines. So these are the 10 major classes of the organic compounds which are having different functions. Okay, so this is the classification of the organic compounds based on the functional group. So till now we discussed about organic compounds, classification of the organic compounds based on the carbon chain present in them. They were classified into four types, and depending on the functional group present in them. So they are divided into many categories depending on the functional group present in them. But I have given the most important 10 classes here. So in the next coming class, we will be discussing about the nomenclature of the organic compounds, where I'll be discussing about the common names and IUPAC names of these 10 different classes of the organic compounds. Thank you.